Hallelujah. Good morning, everyone. We thank the Lord for another wonderful day. To God be the glory. Our eternal rock of ages, everlasting Father, we worship you, Lord. We adore you, Father. We thank you for your goodness, your faithfulness, your love towards us, Lord. For another day, we are grateful. Star Brother, Lord, we thank you. Glory, honor, and power be unto you, O Lord, our God. Eternal Rock of Ages, this is the day, Lord. We have come to meet you because you are our Messiah, you are our Lord, you are our Savior, and you are our healer, the great physician. So, Father, Lord, this morning we are asking you that, Lord, each and every one of us that will come this morning, Father, Lord, for whatever area we need your touch, Lord, we're asking that you will touch us in the name of Jesus, our body, soul, and spirit, that, Lord, you will make us all in the name of Jesus Christ. Eternal Rock of Ages, we're asking you, Father, that you will increase our faith, Lord God Almighty, this morning in the name of Jesus, to trust you, to know that what you have for us, O Lord, and that, Father, will be able to live according to your word in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, Lord, for what you are going to do, Lord, in our midst this morning. We thank you, we bless your name because you are ever faithful. Thank you, Lord. Let us sing what our faithful God we have prayerfully this morning.
Oh, Lord, I come before your throne of grace. I find rest in your presence and fullness of joy. Worship and wonder, I behold your face, singing, what a faithful God there I. What a faithful God have I, you are. What a faithful God. What a faithful.
Singing, what a faithful God.
God, yes, no matter what happened, our God is a faithful God. He's a faithful God. God's protection in the midst of danger is a faithful God. You know, God doesn't promise a world free from danger, but he does promise himself whenever we face danger. So this morning, let us declare Psalm 91. Open your Bible to Psalm 91 this morning, and let us declare God's faithfulness this morning. He's faithful to his word, he's faithful in every way. Psalm 91. Open your Bible and let us read. Declare it affirmatively.
Psalm 91. Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only observe with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. If you say, "The Lord is my refuge," and you make the Most High your dwelling, no harm will overtake you, no disaster will come near your tent. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands, so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. You will tread on the lion and the cobra. You will trample the great lion and the serpent. Because he loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue him. I will protect him, for he acknowledges my name. He will call on me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation.
Amen, amen. That is the promise of God. That is his faithfulness ever sure. Father, we thank you. Lord, we bless your name, Lord, because your word that we have affirmed this morning will be to our life and to our family in the name of Jesus Christ. We stand on that promise, Lord God Almighty, that you are ever faithful. Thank you, Lord, our God, in the name of Jesus. Let us pray this morning that, Lord, let your fire burn all that is not holy in my life, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, let your fire burn all that is not holy in my life, in the name of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, let your fire burn all that is not holy in my life, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, let your fire burn all that is not holy in my life, in the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name. Amen. Pray this morning that, Lord, order my spirit and fashion my life in your will, in the name of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, order my spirit and fashion my life in your will, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, order my children's spirit and fashion their life in your will, in the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name. Amen. Let us pray. That, oh Lord, let your fire generate power in my life, In the name of Jesus Christ, Father Lord, let your fire generate power in my life. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the life of my children, Father Lord, let your fire generate power in their life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. Oh Lord, my Father, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, impart to me thoughts higher than my own thoughts. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord Jesus, impart to me thoughts higher than my own thoughts. In the name of Jesus, Lord Jesus, impart to my children thoughts higher than their own thoughts. In the name of Jesus Christ, oh Lord our God, impart to us, oh Lord, thoughts higher than our own thoughts. In the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. Holy Spirit, come as deep and refresh me. In the name of Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, come as dew and refresh me. In the mighty name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, come as dew and refresh me. In the mighty name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, come as dew. Come and take your place this morning and refresh me. In the name of Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, come as dew and refresh me. In the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. Holy Spirit, you are my guide. Guide me in the way of liberty. In the name of Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, you are my guide. Guide me in the way of liberty. In the name of Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, guide me in the way of liberty. In the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. Holy Spirit, blow upon me such that sin will no more find a place in me. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, blow upon me such that sin will no more find a place in me. In the name of Jesus, that I will not indulge myself in any form of sinful way. In the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, blow upon me such that sin will not have any more place in me. In the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. And Holy Spirit, I need you this morning. Where my love is cold, warm me up. In the name of Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, this morning I need you. Where my love is cold, warm me up in the name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, let your fire warm me up this morning. In the name of Jesus, where my love is cold, Holy Spirit, warm me up. In the name of Jesus Christ, where my children's love is cold, Lord, warm them up this morning. Holy Spirit, warm them up. Let your fire come upon them. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. Let us thank God for his mighty presence in our life. Oh, Father, Lord, I thank you. I thank you, Lord, for your mighty presence in my life, in my family. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I bless your name this morning. Glory, honor, and power be unto you. In the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. Let us pray that, Lord, let my hand become the sword of fire to cut down evil tree. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, Lord, let my hand become the sword of fire. When the Lord turn your hand into a battle axe, Lord, let my hand become the sword of fire to cut down evil trees. In the name of Jesus, whether in my life, in my children's life, in my family, Father, Lord, this morning, let my hand become the sword of fire to cut down evil trees. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name, amen. Let us pray that, let my feet become the thunder of God. As I snap them, let them deafen the enemy. In the name of Jesus Christ, oh Lord, my Father, let my feet become the thunder of God. As I stamp them, let them deafen the enemy. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus, because the word of God says, you shall trample upon serpent and scorpion. Lord, this morning, according to your word, let my feet become thunder of God. As I stamp them, let them deafen the enemy. In the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. Oh, Lord, my Father, let the spiritual rag of poverty in my life be destroyed by the fire of God. In the name of Jesus Christ, you know, you may have money, but if you are poor in health, you do not have anything. Pray this morning. Let the spiritual rag of poverty in my life be destroyed by the fire of God. In the name of Jesus Christ, if you do not know the word of God, the knowledge of the word of God, it is poverty. Poverty in the knowledge of God. He said, my people have been destroyed for lack of knowledge. Oh, Father Lord, lay the spiritual rag of poverty in my life. Lay the spiritual rag of poverty in the life of my children, in the life of my son-in-law, my daughter-in-law. Let your fire destroy them this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ, oh Lord, my Father, lay the spiritual rag of poverty in my life, in the life of my every member of my household. Let it be destroyed. Let it be destroyed by the fire of God. Let it be destroyed by the fire of God. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, Lord, for any one of us that have come into this prayer platform this morning, oh Lord our God, let the spiritual rag of poverty in our life be destroyed by the fire of God, in the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. Every enemy of excellence in my life be paralyzed in the name of Jesus Christ. Every enemy of excellence in my life be paralyzed, be paralyzed, be paralyzed. In the name of Jesus Christ, every enemy of excellence in my life be paralyzed, be paralyzed, be paralyzed. In the name of Jesus Christ, be paralyzed in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Father, let every past satanic achievement in my life be converted to my promotion in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, let every past satanic achievement in my life, in my household, be converted to my promotion in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, let every past achievement in my of satanic achievement in my life be converted to promotion. You are the story changer. Oh gracious Lord, change my story, change the story for this family. Oh Lord, my Father, change our story in the name of Jesus. Let every past satanic achievement in our life, in our household, be converted to our promotion in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Pray this morning that my Father, my Lord, let the shame of my enemies be multiplied greatly in the name of Jesus Christ. For I put my trust in you, and your word said, they that put their trust in the Lord will never be put to shame. But Lord, let the shame of the enemy be multiplied greatly in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, let the shame of the enemy be multiplied greatly in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name. Amen. Pray that, oh Lord, my Father, let the defeat and disgrace of enemy of my progress, let it be multiplied beyond measure in the name of Jesus Christ. Because when God arises in my situation and God turn the story around, oh mighty Father God, let the defeat and disgrace of the enemy of my progress, of my children's progress, be multiplied beyond measure in the name of Jesus Christ. Father Lord, this morning, let the defeat and disgrace of enemy of our progress, of our children's progress, be multiplied beyond measure in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, you are the God that do the impossibility, because with you nothing shall be impossible. So Father Lord, every impossibility that is facing us, either in our career or in our businesses or in our ministry, oh gracious Father, lay this morning, lay the defeat and the grace of the enemy of our progress in every area of our life, in every area of our children's life, let that the grace of the enemy be multiplied beyond measure in Jesus' name, amen. Lord, I ask, let every power planning to turn my life upside down, let their life and themselves be turned upside down instead, in the name of Jesus Christ. Because Father Lord, your word says that the righteous is rescued from trouble and it comes from the wicked instead. So Father Lord, let every power planning to turn my life upside down, let them be the one that will receive the same thing in the name of Jesus Christ. Let their plan boomerang upon them in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, let every power planning to turn my life or to turn my children's life upside down, oh Lord, my Father, you will arise, oh Lord, as according to your word, you will rescue me, rescue my children from the plan of the enemy, and let their plan go back to them, let their plan boomerang upon them in the name of Jesus Christ, because Lord, your word says that the righteous is rescued from trouble and the wicked come instead, and the blood of Jesus Christ has made us to be righteous. So Father Lord, rescue us, oh Lord, rescue us from every plan of the enemy, every plan of the enemy to turn our life upside down, to turn our children's life upside down. Oh gracious Father Lord, this morning fulfill that plan, frustrate that plan in the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus name, amen. In the name of Jesus, I paralyze every satanic inspiration targeted against me, targeted against my children, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I paralyze every satanic inspiration targeted against me and my household, in the name of Jesus Christ. I paralyze them in the name of Jesus, in Jesus name, amen. Because the word of God say that no weapon fashioned against thee shall prosper, and every mouth that shall rise up against thee in judgment, thou shalt condemn. This is the heritage of the servant of the Lord. This morning, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I paralyze every satanic inspiration targeted against me, against my household, against anyone on this prayer platform this day, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. I barricade my life from every satanic opinion in the name of Jesus Christ. By the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, I barricade my life, I barricade my children's life from every satanic opinion in the name of Jesus Christ. I barricade my life, I barricade my children's life from every satanic opinion in Jesus' name. Amen. Heavenly Father, let my divinely appointed helpers begin to locate me from now on, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, let my divinely appointed helpers begin to locate me now, begin to locate me, in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, my Father, let my children divinely appointed helpers begin to locate them, let it begin to locate them now, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, let the divinely appointed helpers that you have ordained to help my children, my grandchildren, my son-in-law, my daughter-in-law, Father, Lord, let them begin to look at each one of them today, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. In the mighty name of Jesus, every lame glory receive life, in the name of Jesus Christ. Every lame glory receive life now, in the name of Jesus Christ, in my life, in my household, in my family. Every lame glory receive life in the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen, amen. I want us to thank the Lord for this section. Thank God for the answers prayer, because he is a mighty God. He's a faithful God. What a faithful God we have. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. Let's go to the word of God quickly. And this morning, I'm going to read from Matthew chapter 15, and I'm talking about the children's bread. Healing is the children's bread. Let's read. We know the story. And now we start reading from verse 21. Leaving that place, Jesus withdrew to the region of Tyre and Sidon. A Canaanite woman from that vicinity came to him, crying out, "Lord, son of David, have mercy on me. My daughter is demon-possessed and suffering terribly." Jesus did not answer a word. So his disciples came to him, urging, "Send her away, for she keeps crying out after us." He answered, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of Israel." The woman came and knelt down before him. "Lord, help me," she said. He replied, "It is not right to take the children's bread and toss it to the dogs." "Yes, it is, Lord," she said. "Even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table." Then Jesus says to her, "Woman, you have great faith. Your request is granted," and her daughter was healed at that moment. Children's bread. Children's bread. Healing is the children's bread. The disciples were puzzled by Jesus' silence. So they asked him to get rid of the woman because she was bothering them with her nagging persistence. From our own perspective, we see that the disciples did not show any compassion for her or sensitive to her needs. Do you know that it is possible to become so occupied with spiritual matters that we miss real need right around us? It is possible. Just as it is possible for you to be so busy with worldly things and you miss spiritual things. See, God wants us to be balanced people. And this can happen, you know, for us to miss spiritual matters. It's possible, especially if we are prejudiced against needy people, if they cause us inconvenience, instead of being bothered or be aware of the opportunity that surrounds us. We should be open to the beauty of God's message for all people and make an effort not to shut out those who are different from us. So even Jesus' word do not contradict the truth that God's message is for all people. No. Jesus said that it was, you know, he said this word, he was in gentle territory when he said, you know, this bread, we cannot give it to the dogs. What Jesus was simply telling the woman was that the Jews were to have the first opportunity to accept him as Messiah because God wanted them to present the message of salvation to the rest of the world. Jesus was not rejecting the Canaanite woman. We should have that in our mind. Probably he may want to test her faith, or he may have wanted to use the situation as another opportunity to teach that faith is available to all people. So no matter the situation, we say that Jesus Christ said, it is not right to take the children's bread, that the healing that this woman is seeking for, it is children's bread. You know, just as you eat your daily bread, we are God's children. Remember the Lord's Prayer, which tells us to ask for daily bread, because bread is a symbol for nourishment. We understand we must believe for nourishment and healing daily. It's a daily thing, daily thing. You do not wait until you are sick. You know, when you wake up, you will have your breakfast, you will have your lunch, you have your dinner. You know, you will have something that day. The same thing, healing, whether physical or spiritual. Healing is to be taken into the body on a daily basis. We do this when we choose the right food, the right vitamin, you know that, and the right supplements. Do not forget We are no longer in the Garden of Eden. However, God still gives us all things that pertain to life and godliness. It is a bit harder than picking food off the tree, but the effort now will provide long-term benefits as we age. So taking care of our body is essential. Our lifestyle is essential. Exercise and rest are also important to the restoration and regeneration of the body. We know that we live in a very, very busy culture. So we must endeavor to find time to rest. Endeavor to find time to rest so that we can feel rejuvenated. It is a challenge for us to put first things first, but the Lord will help us. Now you may ask, what is the reason that God said, this is your bread, take it? Reason God wants you to be healed, to be strong and live healthy? Let me quickly go through it. In the first place, in Genesis, when God created the whole thing, God looked over all he had made and he saw that it is very good. Everything God does or gives is very good. This is the first fact and truth that you have to accept and confess. God does not make people sick. He's not the one who has put sickness in your body. He's not the one, because your body is God's temple. Your body is God's temple. 1 Corinthians 6:19-20 asks us this question. Said, do you realize that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit who lives in you and was given to you by God? You do not belong to yourself, for God brought you with a high price. So you must honor God with your body. After we give our life to Jesus Christ, our body becomes a dwelling place for the Holy Spirit. That is why God wants us to be sound in body and mind. Take care of your body. Stop all this junk food. I will keep crying it out. No. The medical, if you go to a real caring doctor, they will tell you all this processed food. Stop it, and stop it feeding your children. Do you know, I was watching one program on the ADD or something that these kids always have. They find out that from the cereal that we're feeding this our baby, because everything is artificial, that is why it's messing up. But we don't know. We go to the doctor, they diagnose the child with one thing or the other, and they keep punching medication, another artificial. Parents, the 80s is different, from this 20th century that we're in. Everything is artificial. There's no real thing out there. So be careful what you feed your little ones. Try as much as possible to go natural. Those of us who are breastfeeding, breastfeed your baby until that baby say, I do not want it anymore. Don't be in a hurry. It will help. Don't rush to the powder milk. You do not know what is, if you know what is in that kind of powder, oh, my dear, you will know that you are poisoning that little one, little by little. So please, let us No, they are aware. All this processed food is not good for anyone. The medicals, some of them, not all of them, they are saying it out, but it's just a minority. Eat food that is not ultra processed. Stay away from sugar. It's a poison. It's a poison. It's a poison. It's a killer in any form. So another reason why God wants us to be healed is sickness prevents you from doing God's will. If you are sick, you cannot carry out your day-to-day activity of business or ministry effectively. You won't be able to go to church, visit the less privileged, and share Christ with others. No, you will not. But the Bible says in 3 John 1:2, say, dear friend, I pray that you may enjoy good health and that all may go well with your soul. With you, even as your soul is getting along well. God will heal you over and over again because you will, better glorify Him when you are healthy. Another third thing is that God healing you is God's expression of His goodness and compassion. It's a compassionate God. We read it. In Matthew 14:14, Jesus went forth and saw a great multitude and was moved with compassion toward them, and he healed their sick. Acts 10:38 says, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power, who went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. God is the God of healing. God is the God of miracle. Do not let us be deceived. He's still doing miracle. But sometimes it's deeper than on this platform that I want to say that sometimes, what if God doesn't heal? Some of us will have questions. Yes, go and read your Bible. It's not all the people that are sick that God healed. God knows why you want to be healed, why you shouldn't. I don't. But one thing I know is that as long as I do what He says I should do, He will keep me healthy. God is compassionate and merciful. Healing us is one way He demonstrates His mercy. And He will heal you because He loves you. Do not ask me. Those who are not healed, does it mean that God doesn't love them? No, God loves them. He knows what is best for them. And one thing I've learned from my Bible is that because of His love, because of His mercy, if He knows that you are going to go into danger, He will warn you. But if you persist, you will reap what you sow. That is the truth we should tell ourselves. I'm crying out to you now. Stop drinking all this soda, all these sweet things. But you say, that mind your business. Yes. When the result will come, you will know. God will warn you. Then we can pray, we can cry. But you see, if you sow anything, you will reap it. God is a God of mercy. Do not let us take God's grace for granted. God is a God of healing. He will heal us. Another thing is that the price for your healing, for your health, has been paid. It has been paid. That is why you exercise it daily. Our healing, our divine health, is one of the major reasons for Christ's death Isaiah declared it. He said, "He was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And by his stripes we are healed." 1 Peter 2:24 says, "Who his own self bare our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, being dead of sin, should live unto righteousness, by whose stripes ye were healed." By all scriptural standards, you have been healed. The receipt for your healing is in the death of Jesus Christ on the cross. Now, let us rise up and take our healing. See, the word of God says, God will not withhold good things from us. He asked us that question. God asked not to withhold good from others. Same way, he does not withhold good from us. You have a covenant of divine health with God. Exodus 15:26. See, it's good to know our rights. Exodus says, and he said, "If you will give earnest heed to the voice of the Lord your God, and do what is right in his sight, and give ear to his commandments, and keep all his statutes, I will put none of this disease on you, which I have put on the Egyptians. For I, the Lord, am your healer." He has promised. It's a covenant of divine aid. If we do what he says we should do, give earnest heed to the voice of the Lord. He still speaks. He speaks to you through the word. He speaks to you through your dreams. He speaks to you through others, through preaching. And if you do not listen, yes, you will risk, you will reap the consequence. It is God's will for you to be healthy. Let us know that. It is God's will for you to be healthy. In Matthew 8:22, we saw Jesus Christ. And behold, a leper came and worshiped him, saying, "Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean." Then Jesus put his hand and touched him, saying, "I am willing." Immediately his leprosy was cleansed. And finally, God will not ignore your faith and prayer. Our God is a prayer answering God. He does not ignore our prayers and pains as we call on him and act in faith. His power is released for our healing and divine health. So, as you pray, confess and act in faith, God will not ignore your prayer. Rather, he will heal you and restore your health. So this morning we're going to pray. And before we pray, I want us to sing this song. Lift my hands to the Lord.
Be still, there is a healer. His love is deeper than the sea. His mercy is unfailing. His arms a fortress for the weak. Let faith arise. Let faith arise. I lift my head. My refuge, you are. still there is a river that flows from Calvary's tree, a fountain for the thirsty, your grace that washes over me. Let faith arise.
Amen. Let faith arise. Let us confess Colossians 2:15. It says, and having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it. I want us to declare, I am an overcomer. I overcome Satan because of the blood of the Lamb and because of the word of my testimony. I am an overcomer. I overcome Satan because of the blood of the Lamb and because of the word of my testimony. I am an overcomer. My body is the temple of the Holy Spirit of God. My body is the temple of the Holy Spirit of God. I am redeemed, cleansed, and sanctified by the blood of Jesus. I am redeemed, cleansed, and sanctified by the blood of Jesus Christ. The devil has no place in me. The devil has no power over me. No weapon fashioned against me shall prosper. The devil has no place in me. The devil has no power over me. No weapon fashioned against me shall prosper. The weapons of my warfare are mighty through God to put down strongholds. I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me. Amen. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, I command every arrow of witchcraft in my life, come out with all your roots. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus, I command every arrow of witchcraft in my life, in the life of my children, in the mighty name of Jesus, come out. out of my life, out of my children's life, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Every load of infirmity planted by the enemy, come out of me and enter no more. In the name of Jesus Christ, every load of infirmity planted by the enemy, come out of me and enter no more. In the name of Jesus Christ, every load of infirmity planted by the enemy in the life of my children, come out and enter no more. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. Maybe you feel that something is just crawling all over your body. You can feel it crawling in your hand. Sometimes it goes, it moves to your leg, it moves. Pray this morning that let all negative material circulating in my bloodstream be evacuated in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let all negative material circulating in my bloodstream be evacuated. Be evacuated in the name of Jesus Christ. Will there be any negative thing, material circulating in the my children's bloodstream in the mighty name of Jesus? Let it be evacuated. Let it be evacuated in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Say, I drink the blood of Jesus Christ. I drink the blood of Jesus and I have life in me. I drink the blood of Jesus and I have life in me. I drink the blood of Jesus Christ and I have life in me. I drink the blood of Jesus and I have life in me. In the name of Jesus Christ. And now lay your hand upon anywhere you have, you feel that you need God's touch this morning and pray that Holy Ghost fire burn from the top of my head to the sole of my feet. Holy Ghost fire burn in my kidney, in my liver, in my intestine, in my blood. Let the fire of God begin to burn everything that is not of God. In the name of Jesus, from my head, in my brain, in my children's head. In the name of Jesus, Holy Ghost fire burn any strange things in my body that is God has not created and is there, that is not in of God. This morning, Holy Ghost fire, burn it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Let us pray that, Lord, let the blood of Jesus be transfused into my blood vessels in the name of Jesus. Let the blood of Jesus be transfused into my blood vessels in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, let the blood of Jesus be transfused into my blood vessels in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I command every agent of disease in my blood and body organs to die in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I command every agent of disease in my blood and body organs to die in the name of Jesus Christ. I command every agent of disease in the body of my children, in their blood, their organs to die in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Blood of Jesus, speak deliverance and healing into my life in the name of Jesus Christ. Blood of Jesus, speak healing and deliverance into my life, into my children's life, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. I hold the blood of Jesus against you, you spirit. Mention that thing which is troubling you, whether it's diabetics or whatever it is this morning. I say, I hold the blood of Jesus against you, you spirit of diabetes. I hold the blood of Jesus Christ against you, you spirit of high blood pressure. I hold the blood of Jesus Christ against you, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus. You have to flee. Command that spirit to leave you, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus. I hold the blood of Jesus Christ against you, in the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name. Amen. Oh Lord, my Father, let your hand of fire be stretched out upon my life in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, let your hand of fire be stretched out upon my life in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, let your hand of fire be stretched out upon the life of anyone that is sick this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Oh Lord, let your miracle hand be stretched out upon my life in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, you you are still the God of miracle. In the name of Jesus, let your hand of miracle be stretched out upon my life, upon my household. In the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. My Lord, let your deliverance hand be stretched out upon my life. In the name of Jesus Christ, oh Lord, my Father, let your deliverance hand be stretched out upon my life. In the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. Every handwriting of infirmity in my life be wiped off by the blood of Jesus Christ. Every handwriting of infirmity in my life, in the life of my children, be wiped off by the blood of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Oh Lord, my God. Arise and let every enemy of wholeness scatter in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, arise. Let every enemy of wholeness scatter in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, arise. Let every enemy of wholeness scatter in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Let us pray, because sometimes we know that something is not right. We still persist in doing that. Let us pray that God, give me the grace to overcome this. Give me the grace to overcome this. I know that drinking soda is not good, but I'm still drinking it. I need deliverance. You know, let us be plain with God. Be plain that, Lord, I know. Some of us, we have the knowledge. No, nobody needs to tell us that don't do this, but we still do it anyway. Pray that, Lord, give me the grace to overcome this weakness. Give me the grace. I know this is the body of the Holy Spirit. I should take care of it. I should be conscious of what I'm putting into it. Lord, help me to be diligent in my choice of food. You know, food can be medicine as well as poison. Let food be your medicine. We're not saying don't go to medical doctor, no. But let food be your medicine by making intentional choice of food, of what you eat. The good ones are expensive in the store. But what is it? You will go and spend money on the artificial tablets they will give you medicine. Then let food be your medicine. Make a wise choice in what you eat, in what you put into your body. Stop this processing food. Cook. Learn how to cook. It's easy. Stop using this dangerous oil in cooking. The Lord will help us. He wants us to be healthy. Let us pray that, Holy Spirit, release your healing virtue upon my life in the name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, release your healing virtue upon my life in Jesus' name. Amen. Let us begin to thank God that whatever it is that God will convict us of, that the grace to begin a new page, a new chapter in our life, to live healthy, that God will grant us the grace. Father, we thank you. Lord, our God, we bless your name. We say hallelujah to your name, O Lord, for what you are going to do in our life. It is your way that you should be healthy. Thank you, Father, because you already paid the price for our healing, because he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. Glory be to your name. Hallelujah be to your name. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to transition to our 21 fasting and prayer. So I need to stop the recording and start all over again.